We are the 1996 Midwest Conference champions.
We're the 1996 Midwest Conference champs.
We're the 1996 Midwest Conference champions. It's been a long time coming and we did it.
We're the 1996 Midwest Conference champions.
We're the 1996 Midwest Conference champions.
We're the 1996 Midwest Conference champions.
We are the 1996 Midwest Conference champs.
We are the 1996 Midwest Conference champions.
We are the 1996 Midwest Conference champs.
We are the 1996 Midwest Conference champions, baby.
How about them Red Hawks? We're the 1996 Midwest Conference football champions.
We'll be right back. Thank you.
This is where you want to be. This is where you want to be. This is where you've worked. You've worked for this since fifth grade, sixth grade, since you started playing football. All right? All you need to do is go out and play your game. Just play your game. Depend upon each other. Trust the teammate next to you. All right? Trust the guy next to you. Do your job and do it to the very best of your ability. There's going to be 11 players on each side. On each play, it's going to be a war. One-on-one, 11-on-11. Win your individual battle. Beat the guy across from you. Every single play. Beat the guy across from you. For four quarters, we've talked about this all year, you've gotten better every single week. I love you guys. Let's have fun. Trust each other. Let's go out and kick some ass. Let's get it.
Yeah!
Oh, wow.
I think the most memorable play was probably, well, there were several. I think there was the 12 draw against Lakeland.
For me personally, it'd have to be the touchdown I scored against Carroll.
And I think there was the 12 draw against North Park.
It would have to be in Beloit. After I got a sack, Brock Keeler came running in and carried me halfway around the field.
Then I think there was the 12 draw against Carroll.
And I remember the Lawrence game where Joe hurt his arm and just went into a list of profanities. And stuff like that always happens when, like, we'll have a big play and all of a sudden Joe and I look at each other and just laugh all the way down the field. It happened a couple times and it just cracks me up. And that's the things I remember.
Again in the Cornell game when I tackled Hinton and caused a fumble.
I don't know exactly what happened to this day, but all I know is a fight broke out, and I was right in the middle of it. And in the melee, I struck a ref, I guess.
I think it was Carroll. A receiver came across the middle and missed the catch and laid him out.
Most memorable play, when Billy broke the kickoff for the touchdown against Beloit.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Best one, what? Absolutely.
Why?
Because Beloit sucks.
The way you approach the game?
Classic.
Well, I got, actually there's one song that I listened to all the time before the game. I just listened to it like 20 times.
What was that?
It's Fred Bear by Ted Nugent.
I guess I listen to oldies, and I think that's the way I play too, like an old man sometimes.
Probably somewhere around like Pearl Jam or something like that, some alternative rock, something like that, and sometimes rap too, because we kind of, our defense, you know, kind of gets into a groove, you know.
I think a classical or something, maybe something where I like to keep my head, or else I do stupid stuff like jump off sides.
Just like some soft rock or something, because
okay.
I really can't get too pumped up.
Well, I kind of think the alternative, you know, heavy metal type of stuff.
Hard rock, heavy metal, because we're coming right at you.
It kind of an eerie mix. So I guess maybe like Tubular Bells.
I'd have to say hardcore, nitro, psycho, alternative, I'm gonna beat you type of music.
I think the kind of music that probably reflects my coach, kind of mellow music. I'm kind of a mellow coach.